Hello and welcome, I'm Raghav and today we are going to learn how to do visual validation using the Applitools plugin in Katalon Studio, and this is going to be very easy and very interesting. And visual validation is checking the correctness of your websites or your application, how it will visually appear to a user. So until now we have been using Katalon Studio for doing functional testing, but now we can also do visual validation with the help of Applitools plugin, and it includes checking the correctness of your application based on the location of objects, the size, the color, the pixels and so on. And you can actually go to Google and search for my video on Applitools. I will just search for Applitools Raghav, and you can see here is a video. If I go here, let me just show you very quickly. I will pause this, and yes, so this is a video I created earlier, and here in this video I have discussed on what is visual validation, what is Applitools, and then the rest on adding with Selenium script. So you can just see the first two section, and if I take you to this section, you can see this says visual validation includes testing UI components, and it is the validation how the UI appears to the user, or if the UI appears correctly to the user. It includes validation of location, size, shape, color, pixel resolution, fonts, layouts and charts. So this will be very useful. I will copy the link to this video and I will make this available here. So this is what is visual validation, and this is the link, and all these notes will be available along with this video. So you can just watch this, and then here the first thing is we have to add the plugin for Applitools in our Katalon Studio. So I will go to the website katalon.com, and you can log in. You can go to the plugins here. You can see we have plugins, and then make sure that you are logged in. So in my case I have already logged in, so you can just log in using the same email and password that you use for Katalon Studio. And then if you go to the plugins, you will find a plugin for Applitools. Now it is not yet released at the time of creating this video, so I will not find it now, but by the time this video is published you should be having a plugin for Applitools, and you can get it from here. You can just click that plugin. So for example, this is a sample plugin. I will just click it, and then you can click on install, and then when you go to your Katalon Studio, and make sure that you are using the latest version. I am using 6.1.2 as of now. And if you go to the plugin store here and say reload plugins, you should find your Applitools plugins here, the plugin here. Okay, so once you get the plugin, the next step we have to do is we have to get account for Applitools. So step number two is create an Applitools account. So you can create a free account on Applitools, and you can go to the Applitools website, and this is the website, which is applitools.com. Let me also copy this and I will make it available here. So here you can either sign in or sign up. So I will click on sign in. And here you can see in my case I was already having an account. Let me try to log out and show you again. So you can just create an account with your email and password. So here I am already I have created an account. Otherwise you can just click on this try for free, and you can give your details here like your name, your email, and create a password and just create an account. You will be getting an email to verify, so you can just click on that and then you will have an account. And then I already have, so I will just sign into my account and I will say sign in, and the very first thing you will see is the Applitools dashboard. So here is what you will see. This is what you will see. This is the dashboard, and all your tests and runs will be here. So I will show you how exactly you will see the details here. The first thing now you have to do is go to your user here and go to my API key, and you can just copy this API key. So copy your API key, and then The next step is add Applitools API key in Katalon Studio. So you have to go to your Katalon Studio, and when you go to project and go to settings, if you go to plugins, you will have Applitools keyword here, and you can give your key. So this is the key, and then you can leave the app name as it is. Hide caret, keep it to true. Hide caret is if you want to hide the cursor when you are taking the snapshots or when you are comparing any visual validation. You are doing any visual validation, you don't want to see the cursor, so that is keep it to true. Match level can be different, like strict, exact, and so on. I will tell you later on these match levels. And this is the viewport, like this is the resolution that you want to check. And I will say apply and OK. So now we have done the integration, and step 4 now is record test and add Applitools custom keywords for visual validation. So with this plugin, what you actually get is you get some custom keywords that you can apply for visual validation. If you go to your custom keywords here, so if you go to your keywords, you can now see you will have these Applitools keywords. So these are different keywords, like Applitools keywords, check window, and then all these set height caret and check region, and so on. Now we will also have documentation on this, which is not yet released. I will add the link to the documentation in the description of this video as soon as I get the link. So I will add it in the description. So by the time you get this video, you should be having the description, the link in the description. So as of now, it is not there. So these are the keywords, and here now I can create a new test case. So I'm just going to create a new test case. I will say this is demo, or I'll just say this is visual validation demo test, and say OK. And here I will do a recording. So for recording, let me just go to Applitools website again. I will go to this applitools.com. And here, if I go to documentation and I will go to overview, and here if I go to overview of visual UI testing, here is some documentation. And let me just try to look at a sample application that I can use to show you how exactly this works. Yeah, this is walkthrough running a visual UI test and reviewing test results. And here, yeah, this is the application. So this is what I wanted to show to you. So if I go to this application, you can see this is a very simple application, and this is where we can do the visual validation. And you can see there are two different URLs. So if I click on this diff one here, you can see there is a number, and whenever I go and refresh, this number changes. So this is what we can identify and check in our test. So I'm going to add this URL. I'll copy this and go to my test. Click on this record web and give the URL here. So this is applitools.com/hello world 2, and I will use a Chrome browser. And you can see it has gone here to this website. Now what I'm going to do is I will add the custom keyword for visual validation. So I will click on add here. I will say custom keyword, and here I will have all the custom keywords here. And now you can see I have all the keywords from Applitools. I'm going to use this check window from Applitools, and that's it. So whatever window is there, like this window, it will check, and store. And here I will say this is check one or checkpoint one. That's it. I can actually use this as well. Yeah, should be same. So this is fine. This is fine. Now I will go and click on this diff one, and this comes here, and I will again add the check window keyword. So I will say custom keyword, and this is Applitools check window, and here I'm going to say this is check two. So in your Applitools account, it will be stored by the same name, what you, the name you give here. And here I do not need anything here, so that's fine. That's fine. I'll just say okay. It will just store into a variable, so that is fine. I will just say okay, and I will stop this, and I will say okay, and okay. So here I have my test here. Now I will try to run this. So I am going to this URL, and then I am calling the Applitools keyword check window and storing it in by the name check one. Then I am again going to a different URL. I am clicking on the diff button, and then I am again doing the check. So wherever you are calling this check window, this will be used to do visual validation, and it will be stored into your Applitools. So here it should get stored. So I will just try to run this. I will hit this run button and will run with Chrome. And you can see it is going here. And if I go and refresh this, so as of now there is some error. If I go and check what is the error here, so here okay, maybe I'll have to give some variable here as well. I will make this as B, and I will save this and run this again. So there is some error. I will go to the script view. And here, let me try to remove this parameter, and I will save. And I will try to run again. Yeah, looks like this is working now. If I go to my Applitools account and refresh, I can see check one, which is running as of now, and check two is also running. So I will refresh this again, and this is done. I will go back and go here to my Applitools account, and you can see it is showing me as all the results are coming here. Okay, so yeah, everything is here. So my test is done, and if I go to my Applitools account, wherever I have used the Applitools keyword and I have given the name, I am getting the details here. So this is check one and check two. So here if I see, it has actually captured this screen, and it is now doing visual validation. Now because this is the first time I have run this check, so everything is passed, because this will be now used as the base image, and for every subsequent run the check will be done based on this base image, or the comparison will be done with this base image. And if everything is equal or everything is same, it will pass. Otherwise, it will be unresolved and we can then make it fail, or we can just use a new base image. So this is the first image and it is passed. Similarly, this is the check 2, which is on this particular window or this particular page, and this is like this. Now I will run my test again. So I will go and run my test again, and this time let us see what happens. So I will run my test on a Chrome browser again, and it opens the website, and yes, it is doing visual validation. And if I refresh this, you can see check one is running, and you can see it is now check two is also here and it is in unresolved status. And if I again refresh this, and you can also see in our Katalon Studio this failed because there was this keyword failed check window, because there was some differences. And if I go here and refresh this, you can see check one was passed because the image is exactly same as per the base image. So this is passed. However, our check two is failed, and if I go here, you can see the changes. If I resume it, and you can see the changes here. So there was some change in this particular text or this number, and I will highlight the differences. So you can see these are the differences. And if I show you the base image, so this was the base image. So there are some differences from the base image, and this is the new image. So this is the difference. It has captured the differences and it is showing us these are the differences. And here you can also, now the thing is, we have to make it either pass or fail, because Applitools will just show you this as unresolved. And the reason it is showing unresolved is this can be a planned change. So this change can be a valid change, and we want to make this as a new base image. So if you want to make this as a new base image, and if you want to accept these changes, you can click on this button, which is accept the differences, and this will be made as the new base image. Otherwise, you can reject it. Also, you can check some areas that you want to be ignored. So if you just want to ignore this area, you can click here and say ignore. And now you can see this will be ignored. So if you save this, and you can just save this, so as of now this is showing us as passed because we have accepted the changes. Otherwise, we can reject the changes as well. And you will get all your details here, all your data here, and you can run it from Katalon Studio like this. So you can use your Katalon Studio, add the plugin, and then use the Applitools custom keywords to do visual validation like this. And if I go to my notes, let me just see what are the notes. Yes, so we can also say run test and check Applitools dashboard for results. So you can just run your test and then you can check your Applitools dashboard for results. And I hope this was very useful for you. So you can use Katalon Studio to do visual validation like this, and you can just try it out. I will meet you in the next session. Thank you for watching.